Back to Bach Project Duluth Region. My name is Hannah and I am the Regional Director of the Back to Bach Project Duluth Region, and I play the violin.
My name is Claire and I play the violin.
My name is Colleen and I play the viola.
My name is Sophia and I play the cello.
We are all students of Duluth East High School and
we are super excited to play one of our favorite songs. It's called Merry-Go-Round of Life and it's from Howl's Moving Castle.
Before we perform for you guys, we're going to teach you just a little bit about our instruments.
Hi, I'm going to be teaching you a little bit about the violin today. The violin is the smallest of the three instruments that we're going to be showing you today, and I'm going to show you some things that I think are really cool about the violin. This is the chin rest and the shoulder rest of the violin. You hold it like this, and it helps make it way more comfortable when you have these when you play. It provides support, and it makes it much, much more comfortable. These are F holes. When I decide to play, the music comes out of the F holes, and that's how you hear the sound. It comes out of the F holes. These are the strings and the fingerboard right here. And when I put my finger down on a note, it changes based on the string you're on. Here's a B. Here's a G. And that depends on which note I am playing. These are the tuning pegs, which help you tune your instrument. Now I'm going to show you some of the strings. The lowest string on the violin is the G string. The second lowest is the D, then the A string, and then the E string is next, which is unique to only violins because it is the highest string. Now that you've learned a little bit about the violin, next you're going to learn about the viola.
Hi everyone, my name is Colleen and I play the viola, so there's a few things I'm going to teach you about the viola today that you might want to know. A lot of people confuse the violin and the viola because they're both small instruments that sit on your shoulder like this. But the viola is a little bit different because it's bigger and it has the same strings as the cello, not the same strings as the violin. So just like the violin, it does have an A string, a D string, and a G string. But instead of an E string on the top, they have a C string on the bottom, and violas are a little bit bigger than violins and have a little bit deeper of a sound. I really enjoy playing the viola. I've played it for 6 years, and I think it's a really fun instrument, so you should definitely try it out.
Hi everyone, my name is Sophia and I play the cello. One of the first things you'll notice about a cello compared to the higher string instruments is that it's so big. A cello is much, much bigger, much, much bigger than a violin or viola. And so therefore we can't hold and play the cello the same way you'd hold or play a violin or viola. They're playing it up on their shoulder like this, but this goes in between our legs and we just kind of rest it against our chest right here. And that's how we play, that's how you play cello. Another thing that you'll notice is we're strung the same way as a viola. So our high string is an A, and our lowest string is a C. Yeah, so our lowest string is a C, and it's pretty cool because it makes a really, really nice low tone. And we also, instead of having a chin rest, like you would on a violin or a viola, we have this thing called an end pin. So when you're done using your cello, you loosen it and put the end pin back out. But when you're playing, we have a specific length that is like perfect for whatever, how tall you are or how you play it. And so you put your end pin out to the length you like it. And then it stays up so you can play and don't have to worry about it slipping or anything. So yeah, that about sums up the anatomy of a cello. Thanks for learning about the cello with me. I'll see you guys later.
Aren't the instruments just so cool? Now that you know a little bit more about the violin, the viola, and the cello, I want to explain to you more about the piece, Merry-Go-Round of Life. So, Merry-Go-Round of Life is a waltz, which means it has a very distinctive beat to it. It has a very 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 beat to it. So as you listen to our performance, I want you to see if you can really feel the pulse. Also, because it's a waltz, it makes you want to get up and dance. Next, as you listen to our performance, I want you to make up a story. Princesses, dragons, mermaids, anything. It can be anything you want. And without further ado,
here is Merry-Go-Round of Life by Joe Hisaishi. We really hope you enjoy.
Consider starting up an instrument, whichever instrument you choose. And to start off, we have provided your teacher with a list of private lesson teachers around the area to hopefully get you guys started. Thank you!
Thank you.